Everybody loves a parade, and a parade did not happen for the Tampa Bay Lightning in 2004 without the expertise of the general manager of that franchise, Jay Feaster, who joins us now. Jay, welcome. Other than your marriage to Anne, the birth of your five children, I'll even give you graduating from Georgetown Law School. Has there ever been a better day in the life of Jay Feaster than the day the Lightning paraded through the city of Tampa?
Well, it was certainly winning the Stanley Cup. That day's up there as well. But parading through the city of Tampa after winning the Cup, that was quite the occasion. It was a lot of fun.
What do you remember most about it? I know it was very sunny, very warm. Now, the players were wearing this hat along with their T-shirts. And I recall you inside the arena as the parade concluded before 19,000 fans holding up the brass ring of rings of which all the players were going to be sized.
I'll tell you what I remember a lot about that day, and certainly that memory is a great one. I remember having the ring sizing thing with me and having it up there on stage, and I let out my customary whooping and hollering and celebrating that I used to do after we'd clinch a series. But what was really cool about that day was that prior to actually getting lined up and getting in the cars and everything was the fact that we had the opportunity to go into the arena with our families and go out on the ice. The cup was there. The Prince of Wales trophy was there. We had the opportunity to take pictures and all the guys were there. The guys' families were there because the parade, as you know, involved not just the players and coaches and staff, but also their families. And so that's the thing that was really special, was once again being able to relive that with our families.
2 years earlier, you had been elevated to the post of general manager. You had been the man instrumental in John Tortorella being promoted as well. And you began then, and perhaps with Rick Dudley, adding the component parts of Brad Richards, Freddie Modine, Marty St. Louis came along in 01, Hobby Boulin comes along, Dave Andrechuk, Tim Taylor, Dan Boyle. What was the tapestry that you had put together in about 24, maybe 36 months before this, and the approach?
What I thought was significant, and is significant to this day about the 04 team, is the fact that it really is an amalgamation. It's a blend of three different general managers for the hockey club, because you have to go back even before Rick Dudley to Phil Esposito. And you think about the fact that Espo is the one who drafted Vincent LeCavalier. He's the one who drafted Brad Richards. And then Duds comes along, and Duds decides to sign Marty St. Louis as a free agent. He trades and picks up Freddie Modine. And then the big signing, he trades and we sign Nikolai Hobby Boulin, who at that time had been holding out in Phoenix. So those guys, obviously, all parts of what Rick had done. And then I come along, and I said right away when I became GM that we had to get a little bit tougher and harder to play against. And I was able to bring in Andre Roy, Chris Dingman. One of the big trades that I made at the draft after becoming GM was bringing in Ruslan Fedotenko. And that certainly paid off for us in 2004. Even the fact of bringing in John Graham as our backup goalie. If you go back and look at it, Johnny Graham won some really big hockey games for us. And so I really feel to this day, and I do when I watch the replays now, that this group was truly a mix of the previous three GMs, myself, Rick, and Espo.
You add a captain in Dave Andrechuk, and I was working on the math here, and we're going to see game 7 against Calgary, the deciding game. Dave is finally going to get to lift the Stanley Cup. He was almost your age when you were the general manager, and you're able to convince him to come. And this young core, Brad Richards is 23. Marty is still in his 20s. This is still a very young club following the old man with the C, what he meant to you and how they're going to follow his lead through this gauntlet of the New York Islanders, the Montreal Canadiens, the seven-game series, both against the Flyers and Calgary.
No question, the credit for getting Dave to come here to Tampa goes to Rick Dudley and to John Tortorella. Both guys very, very familiar with Dave from his and their time in the Buffalo Sabres organization.
Right.
And so it was Rick that identified that Dave was going to be an important piece of that. And again, I give Rick credit in that he also felt that Tim Taylor, another guy that he knew well and John knew, that Tails was going to be an important part. And I think that that's one of the things that when we talk about that 04 team, and you're right, Paul, the old man in the sea and what he brought, but also what Tim Taylor brought as well. Tails had that experience. Tails, in fact, had won a Stanley Cup previously. And both of those guys, what they delivered in that locker room was they led by example, and they helped John Tortorella as the head coach communicate the message that the coach can't always do it. You need the guys in the room to buy in, and no better way to get that buy-in than when your veteran leadership is saying, this is how we're going to do it. The coaches are right about this. Don't do your own thing. Let's follow the game plan.
You won game six, which some, in fact, Brad Richards told us against the 1,300 games that he played, might be the greatest game that he was a part of. You won game six going on the road in double overtime. Ray Bourque had called Tim Taylor saying that they had done it when he had left Boston. He'd been a teammate of Tails in Boston, gone to Colorado. They had the same situation. They won on the road game six, came back and won the cup, that it was possible. The courage and poise that you saw, the backbone of that team, Brad Richards, who's going to win the Conn Smythe that year, to go into the sea of red, save the series, and then bring it home to Tampa for game seven.
It was unbelievable, Paul. I will tell you that I have never in my life heard anything, not just any hockey arena or any building, I have never heard anything as quiet as the Saddle Dome was following that goal by Marty St. Louis. I mean, imagine, the Stanley Cup is in the building. At one point in time, they actually had the Stanley Cup. The Royal Canadian Mounted Police were there. They actually had the cup in the Zamboni tunnel. And it was, I mean, it was right there. It was visible. It was ready to go. The celebration was ready to begin. And Marty scores that goal. And you could not believe the silence in that building at that time. And you're right, it did take tremendous courage. I mean, to go into that building, coming off of a very demoralizing overtime loss at home in Game 5, and then you go in there, and the anticipation is such, and to go in and win that game and force that Game 7, that group was so resilient. And they really, you look back on it, and in so many ways, they were unflappable.
So from Game 6 and that improbable win to Game 7, winning the Stanley Cup, Hobby Boulin, a great postseason. Now we're going to celebrate this evening with this parade. Jay, you're now the executive director of community hockey development, which is the gold standard, I must say, throughout the National Hockey League of how to grow the game at all levels and among fans of all ages. What did those 4 months, going from being a 500 hockey team, 4 months and 2 weeks to winning the cup, how did that propel all of this passion for the sport across the Bay and the Sunshine State?
Well, first of all, I have to say that they've given me a promotion since, and now I'm a VP, not just an executive director. So I got a title bump, which is a good thing. And I will also say, and I mean this in all sincerity, that while there was no question that back then, that 4 months and obviously the run through June winning the cup, it was huge as far as what it did to help make this a hockey town. But there's no doubt that this market became a hockey town for good, thanks to Jeff Vinnick. And there's, I mean, we have that distinction of having won in 04, but as you very well know, we couldn't fully capitalize on that because immediately there's a lockout in September and we lose the entire 2004-05 season. And so we did our best. Ron Campbell, our team president, I thought he did at the time, I thought he did a great job keeping the cup in the community, and we're going out and visiting businesses and season ticket members and sponsors and everything. I mean, I thought we managed it as well as we possibly could, but there's no doubt that we lost momentum. And then there's an ownership change, and until Jeff Binnick gets here and says, I'm going to commit to growing hockey in this market, I mean, that's when it really took off. So in the position that I'm in now,
right,
I credit Jeff Binnick even more than anything we did in 04, because without him, we don't see the kind of exponential growth, and we aren't considered the gold standard that you referenced.
Well, tonight, the parade will air on Fox Sports Sun. Again, I have my hat here, Jay, item one. I have the Dave Andrechuk Foundation hat with him lifting the trophy. And then this, I haven't even washed it since the day. It is the T-shirt, Jay. I can't wash it. And all the guys' names on the back. Remember the adage, and I think it was Tim Taylor from Freddie Shiro, you win the cup and you walk through time forever together. Do you feel that camaraderie each and every day among the men that wore the sweater?
There is no question. That's Freddie Shiro told those Flyers teams back in the 70s that win today and we walk together forever. And Tails had articulated that and articulated it again in the locker room afterward. And I will tell you that that is true. That group of guys, they're so special. And there really is there's a family bond. There's a familial love within that group.
And there's so many of them are still involved with you and living now here in the Bay Area. Jay, enjoy game 7 tonight. Enjoy the parade once again this evening. And thank you so much for joining us on Fox Sports Sun.
My pleasure, Paul. Thank you.